Hello, Mr. Stanerson here. I want to take you through a couple pointers on the Waves on a String FET activity that can help you be more successful. The one thing that you're going to be doing here is monitoring and looking for wavelengths on this string, which is like kind of these beads that are connected between the ends. You want to change this to oscillate first, and that's going to be able to set up that wave pattern that you can measure, okay? You also want to make sure you use this restart button, so that resets things. And then you can adjust the controls between trials and take your new data. I highly encourage you to set the dampening to none. Use an amplitude range that is reasonable, and that think about your frequency. Now, your frequency range, especially for the first experiment where you're measuring wavelength and frequency, you want to have a big enough range where you can measure things, but you don't want to have something that is on the extreme ends of either side. So I'm going to start with about a point, let's say 0.5, around that for my initial frequency. Change the tension to medium for this. That's the best case scenario. And then we're going to play the wave until it starts to bounce back. And I'm going to pause it before doing so, so then we can measure the wavelength. Before I do that, I'm going to turn the ruler on so I get a measurement of wavelength, and then I can record the wavelength and the frequency that I've chosen for this particular trial. So I'm going to hit play, and before it hits the other side, I'm going to pause it because I want to look for just one wave. So I'm going to fast forward this a little bit, and now I know I have a repeating pattern. Here we go, one complete cycle between before when it gets back again is about 7.24, about 7.6 centimeters. Now, it's up to you if you want to keep this in centimeters or change it to meters. As long as you're consistent, the data trend will be the same. So I'll leave that up to you as you're taking and collecting this data. The next trial, you want to hit restart, and that resets your string to zero, and then change the frequency, but keep everything else the same. So maybe about 0.9, let's try that. I'm going to, again, do one wave until it bounces back. Make this step forward just a little bit until I get a full wave. And now I can go from trough to trough if I want to do that. I'm at about 4.3, let's say, centimeters. Or I could fast forward a little bit and I can go from start of the wave all the way through to the start of the wave again about 4.3 centimeters for that wavelength. Notice as your frequency increased, something happened to the wavelength. Those are the things I want you to pay attention to. Make a data table and then make a graph of that relationship in this experiment. Each time you change something, make sure you hit restart and reset things. Now, if you find that you're getting very large or very small numbers, you might be on the edges of either the frequency or the amplitude. So maybe refine and make adjustments so that you're getting not all the way to the end of one side. You're going to get better data. Please reach out if you have some questions. Thanks and have a great day.